Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. For those of you who haven't been here before, my name is Lori Hill and I make videos about plastic surgery. I'm not a plastic surgeon. My degree and background are in the dental field. My goal is to show you that beauty is attainable. It's also to remove the veil of secrecy that surrounds plastic surgery to diminish the stigma because everybody deserves to feel beautiful. If that sounds good to you, please subscribe. Today we're going to be talking about the beautiful and iconic singer Mariah Carey, so let's jump right in because we've got a lot to cover. Mariah Angela Carey was born on March 27, 1970 to her parents Patricia and Alfred Carey. Patricia, her mother, is of Irish descent and a former opera singer and vocal coach. Mariah's father, Alfred, was African-American and Afro-Venezuelan and worked as an aeronautical engineer. The family had three children, with Mariah being the baby of the family. Here we see Mariah as a young adult. Let's talk about her natural beauty traits. Mariah has nicely balanced facial features. Her face is also very symmetrical. We can't talk about Mariah without mentioning her gorgeous, naturally curly hair and her luminous skin. Has this woman ever had a pimple in her life? The first period in Mariah's life where I noticed she had started to experiment with plastic surgery was during her marriage to Tommy Mottola. So let's talk about that period in her life. Mariah's career took off when Tommy Mottola, the CEO of Sony Music and the man who she would later go on to marry, was given her demo tape while at a party that Mariah attended. Tommy heard the tape on his way home and immediately turned around and went back to the party to track down this unknown talented singer. After finding Mariah, Tommy became very taken with her, and the two ended up getting married. Mariah made an absolutely stunning bride. The marriage was more than just a romantic partnership. It was also a business relationship. One that would lead Mariah to becoming a huge star under Tommy's watchful eye. Now, it was during her marriage to Tommy that I believe Mariah had her first cosmetic procedure, a small conservative bust augmentation. The augmentation was so slight that if you didn't know to look for it, you may have thought it was natural. In this photo, it's pretty clear that there are small implants under the skin and that the implants themselves are quite far apart. And it's actually kind of crazy that she was able to get a breast augmentation during this time because Tommy wanted her to dress very conservatively. In fact, his favorite outfit for Mariah was a little black dress. Another procedure Mariah likely had at this time was a brow lift. It's quite obvious when we look at Mariah's before photo and contrast it with her after photo that her eyebrow heads and tails have been raised. After Mariah's marriage to Tommy ended, she really grew into herself. She shed the drab black dresses for colorful and sexy outfits. She busts out with this beautiful femininity. She becomes like the woman that she's always wanted to be. We see her wear a lot of colorful, a lot of sexy and revealing outfits, and she's young and she's free, and we all feel her joy. It was during this time that Mariah had her second bust augmentation, and this augmentation really looked great on her. I think it suited her body a lot more. I think the diameter and the size of the implants really fit her chest wall. It made her whole body look more balanced. We do see cosmetic surgery for different reasons, and it is pretty common to get cosmetic surgery after a divorce. I think for her, it was showing the world that she's in control. I think it empowered her. We also noticed that Mariah is starting to fill out more. She's really grown into that beautiful, curvaceous body that we know Mariah Carey for. It's also around this time that Mariah gets her first rhinoplasty. Now, let's compare and contrast her before and after. The main goal of this rhinoplasty was to narrow the dorsum of her nose and to make the tip look as petite as possible. Now, Mariah has had more than one nose job, so here is a progression photo for you to look at. The difference in her original nose and her nose job nose is quite striking when we look at this photo that is over a 20-year span.
Now, it was sometime after this that I noticed Mariah's smile had changed. I believe there was a gum cutting procedure done, as well as veneers to give her gums and teeth a uniform height. During this same period, there was a point where Mariah just started looking different, and no one could quite pinpoint why. This is when I believe Mariah got cheek implants. Now, they're kind of hard to show in before and after photos, but take a look at this photo. Do you see how her cheeks now take up more of her face? Do you also see how this line angle has increased so that her cheeks are now making this area wider? Even though Mariah started out with some cheek fullness, her cheeks never looked this large, and there are no weight changes in any of these photos to account for the difference.
Do you see how they completely changed the shape of her face? From a long, narrow one to more of a heart or a diamond shape.
The type of cheek implant that does this is called a combined submalar cheek implant, which I will show right here.
The style, size, and height of her cheeks has really remained consistent. And had this been filler, we would expect to see periods of time where her cheeks look smaller, other times where they looked overfilled, we would see different variations. And when I say filler, I also mean fat transfer, because during this time, they were doing a lot of fat transfer.
In 2008, Mariah Carey married Nick Cannon, who is an actor, writer, and producer. A few years later, the couple was blessed with twins. Mariah reported gaining 70 pounds. 40 pounds was water weight, and the rest she said she lost with Jenny Craig. This is Mariah on the cover of a magazine shortly after giving birth, announcing that she had lost 30 pounds in 3 months. Coincidentally, Mariah became a Jenny Craig spokesperson that year. Now, it's in 2011 when I believe that Mariah had both a tummy tuck and liposuction. Many plastic surgeons speculated that although Mariah had claimed it was dieting and working out that made her belly get so flat, that in actuality, it was help from a plastic surgeon. Looking at her tummy, we see the obvious characteristics of a tummy tuck, like the perfectly round belly button. This is not the belly button Mariah started out with, and those of us who have had children know that post-pregnancy belly buttons are often not a perfect circle. Also, all of the dieting and exercise in the world will not get rid of a loose skin problem after pregnancy, especially at an older age. In addition, I believe that liposuction was also used to help her lose the fat pockets that don't always come off so quickly after pregnancy. If she had lost all of the weight just from dieting and exercise alone, she would have had a much more gaunt appearance to her face and throughout her whole body. Anthony Yoon, a plastic surgeon who's also a YouTuber, said, "Mariah looks amazing. Her tummy is completely flat and there's no excess skin anywhere, including above her strangely round belly button. I've seen a lot of patients who have had twins. I think it's highly unlikely that Mariah became as flat and stretch mark free as she has after having twins without a plastic surgeon's help. In addition, her belly button looks like a tummy tuck belly button. I suspect that she underwent a tummy tuck a few months ago. Although it's her business whether or not she underwent this surgery, I do think it's a bit disingenuous to be a paid spokesperson for a diet plan when you've secretly had body contouring surgery." Mariah and Nick sadly end up announcing their divorce in 2014. Sometime within the year following the announcement of their divorce, I believe Mariah got a BBL and a new bust augmentation to an even larger implant size. The BBL gave her that molar shape that we're used to seeing nowadays on Instagram and on some of the Kardashian women. And to me, she looks great with the extra curves. The larger implant size also suits her tall frame very well. Sometimes taller people can get away with a larger bust implant size.
I know that she struggled off and on with her weight during these years, and I think the thing that made it really bad is she got fat shamed. Doesn't matter how strong you are, fat shaming is something that can really get to you. So I really feel for her, and I totally understand her wanting to do everything to look her best. So I do think she's had liposuction off and on in these years, trying to get back to the shape that she's most comfortable with.
Now, I notice it's also during this time that Mariah's eyes start looking more uplifted at the corners, as well as her forehead starts looking smaller. She may have had another brow lift that snipped away excess skin from her forehead, thus giving her a smaller forehead as well as more upswept eyes and cheeks. During this same year, Mariah also had PLLA gluteal injections, according to legal documents that were released to the public. Now, let's talk about Botox and dermal fillers. Mariah's forehead is completely smooth, which is likely the result of regular Botox injections. She's also had Botox around her eyes, as she has no crow's feet when she smiles or expresses herself. Mariah's cheeks, although likely cheek implants, now look even fuller and lumpy when she smiles. This may be the result of dermal filler over her cheek implants. Her lips also have retained their fullness, although she is older, which may be the result of lip filler.
Now, it was around 2017. The show Entertainment Tonight came out with a story of Mariah Carey having gastric sleeve surgery, and people were freaking out because, in our minds, gastric sleeve is only for the very obese.
In a gastric sleeve surgery, 75 to 80% of the stomach is removed, and a sleeve that functions as a new stomach is made. Your hunger and desire to eat decrease, and you lose about 60 to 70% of your excess weight within 1 year of the surgery. The best candidates for gastric sleeve surgery are people with a BMI of 40 and over and have more than 100 pounds to lose. If Mariah didn't fit any of these requirements, she could have still had the surgery, but paid for it out of pocket instead of using health insurance.
If we think about it through the perspective of Mariah, it's like she's under constant pressure to look a certain way. I can see why she had this surgery. Now, Mariah's people never confirmed that she had this surgery, but they never denied it either. Other news outlets also confirmed that she did have this surgery. And after the surgery and in the years that followed, we see an absolutely stunning woman. The work she did on herself really paid off, and I think it made her happier and more confident too. I'd rather have people have surgery and have it make them happy because happy people are way better to be around than unhappy people. How much does it cost to have a look like Mariah Carey? I'm going to list the typical price ranges for all of the procedures, but you can assume that Mariah paid top dollar. So I'll be adding up her total according to the top of the price range.
Three bust augmentations, 45,000. Two brow lifts, 26,000. Two rhinoplasties, 30,000. Cheek implants, 11,000. Veneers on 16 teeth, 32,000. Gum contouring, 15,000. Tummy tuck, 14,000. Three liposuction sessions on four areas each, 96,000. Gastric sleeve surgery paying cash, 25,000. BBL, 15,000. Dermal filler and Botox maintenance, 5,000 yearly. PLLA injections, 32,000. Total beauty investment, $346,000.
No matter what, Mariah Carey will always be a legend. Coming up next is my video on Cindy Kimberly, who's an Instagram influencer who was discovered by Justin Bieber. Or check out my celebrity playlist with celebrities like Kylie, Kendall, Lady Gaga, Britney Spears, and more.